and you talking about we're outplaying you? Now, do you hear how that sounds to your audience? You claim you're God and we're outdoing you? You need to come up with another word besides bigot for that, sir. That's the best you can do, is you're God and we're playing games and we're actually making you look bad.
Well, it depends on, when I was in school.
Okay, here we go with another story.
Never.
Which that brings to my mind that Master Farad Muhammad had to go to school. How about we address a new question? Did Master Farad Muhammad have to go to all the universities?
School of mine ain't reason with you. They make fun of you.
I'm not making fun of you. I'm asking you a simple question. Did Master Farad Muhammad have to go to school?
Yes, he did.
Okay, now why would Mahdi, Allah, the Son of God, have to go to school? Now, in the Bible, did Jesus have to go to school?
Yes, Jesus went to school.
Can you prove that to us today?
Yes, the book that he was reading, wasn't it?
Can you prove? Because it seemed like to me that I remember that it was
said... In the book of Luke, you playing these little games, but you ain't asking me nothing I can't. I don't say things that I ain't capable.
But well, see, what we're saying is that God had to go to all the universities of the land.
He did Jesus go to school.
Now, you're going to show us where Jesus went to school.
This is in the fourth chapter of Luke and the 16th verse. It says, and he came to Nazareth where he had...
the synagogue being glorified the world.
Brother, hold on. Tell the caller that I'm reading and to listen.
God is reading and listen, is what you're saying.
Chapter of Luke and the 16th verse. It says, and he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read.
Okay, now I'm reading from John 7:15, and all of our viewers can see it. And the Jews marvel, saying, how knoweth this man letters, having never learned? Now,
that's like asking a person, how does a man understand science, but he ain't never went to our school and got our degree.
What we're trying to get at is, why did Master Farad Muhammad have to go to all the universities? And in fact, Mr. Muhammad, we're actually getting to a second question is, how can a man actually claim that he went to all the universities in the world?
We not finished with the first one. You asked me, did Jesus go to school?
No, I asked you, did Farad Muhammad go to school? And you jumped over on Jesus right quick.
Sir, you asked me, did Jesus learn to go to school? And I said, yes.
No, I said, why is it that Jesus didn't have to go to school? If you're going to quote me correctly. I said,
tell you that Jesus didn't go to school. You asked me after I said that Master Farad Muhammad went to school. You asked me, did Jesus have to go to school? I said,
no.
Yes.
No, that's not what I said. I said, why is it?
You and show it to you, and then you try to change the question.
No, I said, why is it that Master Farad Muhammad had to go at all these universities, but Jesus didn't? And you wanted to jump over and say, well, Jesus did.
You asked me, did Jesus go to school?
Okay, all right.
Told you, yes.
All right, so how is it? Can you tell me how that one person can go to all the universities in the world? Let's listen to Elijah Muhammad.
No, sir.
We don't want to listen to Elijah Muhammad?
He didn't say that he went to all.
We're going to listen. We'll let the audience decide.
Go to this university and enroll there. And other universities he mentioned to me. And finally he told me this, that he had studied every... educational systems of the civilized world.
How about that? Every educational system in the civilized world. And we heard it out of his mouth.
He's been talking about every educational system in every university.
He said every educational system in the world. What are you saying?
No, sir. Every educational system is not every university.
Okay. All right. Then I'm fine with that then. What is every educational system in the world? How about you tell us?
Means every civilization. Every civilization has its own educational system.
Okay. All right. So he could speak the language. How many languages?
Muhammad studied the civilizations of the earth.
Now, why would Muhammad have to study the civilizations of the world? Please tell me.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said that that's what civilized means. It means to teach people the knowledge and wisdom.
Our question is, why does Allah need to go to school in every educational system in the civilized world? Why does he need to do that? Can you tell us that? I thought he was all-knowing.
No, all-knowing.
Okay, let's ask it this way. Have you been to all the educational systems of the civilized world? And we have silence.
Let's go back to the first question you asked.
You don't like the way the questioning is going?
First of all, the Holy Quran tells you that Allah is the best knower. And how in the world are you going to be one who knows if you don't travel and study?
Sir, are you telling us that Allah has to travel and study? Are you honestly on television tonight telling us that Allah has to travel and study?
I'm telling you that over in the book of Genesis, it tells you that.
That Allah has to travel and study?
On the way to Sodom, he said, I'm going down there to see if it's as bad as out on earth.
Okay, that's traveling and studying in all the educational systems of the civilized world. Sir, anybody in grade school knows that that is not the same thing. We went down to Lot.
You see how when they in over their head, they can't address nothing, you think?
This is simple, sir.
Yes, maybe.
Genesis 18 saying we're going down to Sodom means that he went to all the education. Was there a school in Sodom? I missed that. Was there a school in Sodom? Or was he going down to see what the homosexuals were doing? Now, are you saying...
What do you need to go down there for if you already know?
That's a far cry from going to all the schools in the civilized world, sir. Saying that you went down...
No, according to you, he shouldn't have to go down there.
Okay, that's fine. But now, let's get back to the question of, does Allah need to go to school?
Yeah, see, now you're backing up.
No, I didn't back up. We loved how you did that. As a matter of fact, we will replay this on YouTube, too. We're going to cut these clips up into small clips where we ask you questions. And here's what you're going to hear on the internet. We're going to hear the New Nation of Islam said that God had to go to school. And where did he go to school, folks? He went to school at Sodom and Gomorrah. Man, that is going to be really good for the New Nation of Islam. Do you want to back that up?
What is, brother and sister, that they are guilty of doing the same thing that they did with Jesus.
And yes, sir, you are a far cry from Jesus.
No, sir,
Jesus was not able to be trapped
by...
The
only thing that's unchanged... It's the skin that the mind is in. But the mind that you are addressing me with is the same wicked mind that Jesus people had.
Okay. Well, what's happening here? Are you doing okay? I mean, you
getting twisted into something else.
Now, did I twist or did you say that Jesus went down to learn something, God went down to learn something in the school at Sodom and Gomorrah? Because that's what we were talking about, going to school at all the universities in the civilized world, and you got God going to school at Sodom.
Tell you that God went to school at Sodom and Gomorrah.
Well, then why'd you bring it up in a discussion about God going to school then?
Duh, because you said that God didn't have to go to school.
I simply ask, did Allah have to go
I
to school?
I told everything.
Okay. Now, what we're doing is we're going right down through here, and it just doesn't seem that you're going to answer any of our questions.
You don't want to ask me why did I bring it up. You think that I'm not like you. When you quiet, you ain't listening to me. You thinking about what you gonna say next.
Well, I appreciate that. I am thinking ahead. I really don't have to listen because I know that you're not gonna answer. It was
evident. Did I tell you a bigot?
Excuse me?
Yeah.
What'd you say?
Okay. All right. He just proved it.
You just proved that I'm a bigot.
You notice. That's why he didn't understand why I went to show him that God, the Lord, had to go to see if Sodom was bad as he had heard.
Okay, is that God going to school? Is that what you're saying now? You're clearing it up?
No, sir. I ain't clearing nothing up. I'm just saying what I told you before.
Okay, folks.
Even though I brought it up.
For our community, the Islamic God has to go to school.
There is no such thing as the Islamic God.
Okay, the Allah of the message to the black man. How about that? He had to go to school.
Allah is not the Islamic God.
Okay, the God of the message to the black man. The Allah of the Nation of Islam, not the New Nation of Islam, but the Nation of Islam had to go to school. Now, then when he got caught going to school, His messenger says to us that God of the Bible went to school, and guess where the classroom was? Sodom and Gomorrah. I wonder what the subject was.
You know what he's doing? They have something called a straw man. And you notice now, I'm just saying one thing, and when he goes to rebut me, he says, you said this and you said that when I didn't say that.
Well, you said the same thing to Hoger. You basically tried to make it like Hoger was saying something that he really wasn't. Sir, we've seen you come and go. Now, we've got another screen up. How about this? The black nation is self-created. Would you address that tonight? The black nation is self-created while the white race is made of one of the gods and scientists of the black nation. Their time on our planet is nothing compared to the time that we have been in the universe on the planet. It's hardly a factor of a minute if we divide their 6,000 years into the billions and trillions of years. Now, are you saying the black man has been on the face of the earth for 66 trillion years, or did I misunderstand the message to the black man?
No, I'm not saying the black man been on the earth for 66 trillion years. I'm saying that the black man been on the earth for over 78 trillion years.
Okay, that's even better. 78 trillion years the black man's been on the face of the earth. Is the black man self-created?
The Holy Scripture calls the black man the Ancient of Days.
Okay, that's what you say. But I know that there's no place in the Scripture where it calls the black man the Ancient of Days. Now,
the Scripture also says that the original man is God.
Okay, now let's get to this. The black nation is self-created. Could you explain that to us tonight?
That simply means, you know, the word create means to start from nothing.
Okay.
The first man is a created man because there was no man before the first
Okay,
man.
So you're saying that the black nation is actually eternal.
Oh, sir, I'm saying what I said.
Okay, say it again.
You ask the question, then I go to answering it, and then you start talking about you saying this or you saying that. No, I'm saying what I'm saying.
Okay, I'm asking you to say it again because this is something that most of the people in our audience have never heard before. You want to be a teacher?
It means to start from nothing.
Okay, you said the black nation started from nothing.
When you look at the human beings on the earth, the Scripture already says that from one blood, all men were made. Okay, then we know that one man is the father of all human beings.
And you're sure that's what that means? Couldn't that mean that all men have the same kind of blood? Or do you say the black man has a different kind of blood than the white man? Because I know you don't want us to intermarry.
Greg Amendo?
I said,
did he tell you all that light skin is recessive and dark skin is dominant?
I'm saying, do we have the same blood? Because I know you don't want us to intermarry. Is that not true?
All human beings come from the black man.
Okay.
There's no such thing as a human being.
Okay. Can I ask you a question, Mr. Minister Muhammad? Did Master Farad have a white mother?
Notice, the reason you told me to call you Johnny is because you wanted to get familiar with me and call me something that I'm not. And Mr. Muhammad ain't talking to you.
Who is talking?
The Son of Man.
Okay, now I have on tape one of your men saying that I can address you as Minister Muhammad on the phone.
Not one of my followers ever told you that you can address me as Mr. Muhammad.
Okay, well, you tune in tomorrow night and we'll see if either Michael or Jamar said I could address you as Minister Muhammad, because I said I was not going to address you as Son of Man.
No, I told him why you told him that you wanted me to call you Johnny.
Okay, well, that's fine. That's how you feel about it. Everybody in this area knows that everybody calls me Johnny.
I'm not interested in what people call you. Okay, I called you what you said called me.
But what we are interested in is what the community already knows. Everybody here knows that I don't let anybody put me up on a pedestal, call me Allah, or call me Mahdi, or call me Son of Man.
I'm not interested in what you do, about you do what you do.
Okay.
Mr. Muhammad ain't the one talking to you.
When's the last time we did see him?
The Son of Man is talking to you.
Okay. Now, that's what you say.
This is a scriptural discussion with the Son of Man.
Okay, that's what you say. But what we're asking is why is it that if the black nation came from nothing, why didn't Elijah Muhammad say that? He said they're self-created.
Well, if you understood what create means, you would understand that matter can neither be created nor destroyed. Okay. When we say nothing, it's just like when you go out in the woods and somebody asks you, what do you see?
Okay, but I'm confused, Minister Muhammad. I'm confused because, now y'all help me if I'm wrong here. Who had a white mother?
You're trying to confuse the people.
Okay, Farad Muhammad, can you tell me if Farad Muhammad had a white mother?
We ain't never had a time in this universe where there was nothing here.
Okay, if Farad Muhammad's mother was white,
didn't I tell you that's the way people do when they can't deal with the subject that you have? Now, he accused me of jumping from one subject to another and not finishing that. But you notice, when I can answer a question that
Sir, you didn't answer anything. Self-created, you are a man from Mississippi, and you haven't been to even the school in Sodom and Gomorrah yet, much less the schools that Farad Muhammad went to, and you want to interrupt us in the middle of this thing and start saying, I'm not Minister Muhammad, you must call me son of man. You haven't demonstrated any credibility, just some guy from Mississippi who got a television feed and wants people to call him the son of man. And nobody ever heard of you. Elijah Muhammad never heard of you. Farad Muhammad never heard of you. The Nation of Islam never heard of you. And the only reason we know of you is because somebody didn't like the way that Malvester handled Islam. I'm telling you, he did Islam, the Nation of Islam, as well as you're doing.
I noticed that, you get a little rowdy there.
I noticed that you're pretty docile compared to what you were last Friday. Now, you were really riled up last Friday, but you are very docile on our program. What's the problem?
I'm not any different tonight than I am.
Oh, you are so different, and we're going to play you side by side. As a matter of fact, we already played how you were. You told Hoger, don't you tell me how long we're going to go on my broadcast. Don't nobody tell me how long we're going to go on our broadcast, and you're like a little puppy on our broadcast. Laughing and carrying on, just a friendly conversation, and you were a big old lion on that other program. Now, why don't we get back to where did you come from, sir? Where did you come from? Who announced you? Who is your witness?
You notice everything he says, he speaks to himself.
I'm looking right at you, and you're talking back to me, so I must be talking to you at least.
I done walked into mental institutions and saw people standing around doing that.
Okay, I'm mental, and I'm a bigot, and you haven't answered any of the questions that matter. Who announced you? Who gave you confirmation? Are you just some person from Mississippi who got a broadcast into the internet up in Detroit? What happened to you in Detroit? Tell our callers what happened to you in Detroit.
That's an old trick of white people.
Okay, now we go into race. And are we headed to race?
You shame.
Are we headed to race?
Are you ashamed of who you are?
No, I want you to go to race. Go ahead.
Well, then what you get upset when I
didn't get upset. I was waiting for you. Come to race.
This is what white people have did to us ever since we've been in this country.
Okay.
You stack the deck.
Now, you're God. Wait a minute. You're God. This is God talking, y'all. This is the audience.
That's
audience.
What you done to Jesus.
This is God talking. White people have done something to God. Sir, surely you're not going to make the argument that Allah Mahdi, the Son of Man, is actually under... Still today, you've had all this time, and you're telling our audience that white man is doing it to God again? Surely you're not going to make that argument.
I ain't said nothing about the white man doing nothing to God again.
You said you're God, you're the Son of Man, and you're complaining about me, a white man who is a bigot, mentally. What kind of mental problem do I have?
Do you not see how far your country and government have fallen?
Okay, now we're into politics. Okay, keep going.
Politics, we into reality.
Okay.
Enough talking about what you do. You ain't doing nothing to me. I'm the one doing it.
Okay. Well, while we're in politics, who is the president?
Who is the president?
Who is the president?
What are you doing in there?
Who is the president?
Put him there.
Did you say who put him there?
Y'all people put him there.
I tell you, can I find out? Can you tell me, Mr. Muhammad? Can you tell me if I can find out who voted for whom in Mississippi?
Because I believe in sick of white people.
I believe that Mississippi turned out that the 47% of the black population in Mississippi turned out in a big way for President Obama. Now, who did you say put him in?
The black vote did not put President Obama in that office.
All right, so can I ask you this? If the black vote had gone the other way, would he have got in the office?
I believe he would have.
You telling me that if the Democratic Party had lost all the black vote, that Barack Obama would be president?
I'm telling you that black people don't make up but about 12% of the population.
I tell you that 12% of the population can definitely change the presidential election.
I'm telling you that.
And I think everybody who's listening knows if they had 12%, they would be happy. If they could change 12% of the vote, they would be extremely happy. Now,
when all of the black people in America voted for Jesse Jackson, and quite a few of them,
they did not all vote for Jesse Jackson.
So now, white people elected Barack Obama, and I say they did a good job.
They
did the right thing.
You know what? I think that the white people are coming around, and they're actually disproving what the Nation of Islam says. Because, the Nation of Islam actually says that the white man would never do anything good for the black man, and you just gave us a plug, and I appreciate it. The white people are coming around. They're being fair. They're willing to elect a black man. I say we've come a long way. What's wrong with you?
I told you when you were sitting up talking about what I'm talking about white folks doing to God, and I told you, you ain't doing nothing to me. I'm the one doing everything to y'all now.
Now, it sounded like you were complaining and whining and started that white stuff a while ago, and I just simply interjected. You're God. Surely you can do something about it.
Look here. Your man standing up on City Hall steps trying to marry another man.
Are you saying there's no black homosexuals? Surely you didn't say that.
I'm saying that y'all are ringleaders.
We're the ringleaders, but that's fine. I don't even know if what population number there is. But you see how far we've gotten off? This is what a man does that can't answer the questions. He wants to get into politics. He wants to get into mental institutes. He wants to get into the dictionary. You've been everywhere but in the message to the black man. And you know what, Mr. Muhammad, you're suiting us fine. This is fodder. It's wood for the fire.
Whenever I get in discussions with people, I go where they take me. You took me to these places.
I took you right here. I didn't take you to a mental institute. I didn't take you to school in Sodom and Gomorrah. You went there all by yourself, and I do love it. I want to tell you thank you for that wonderful clip that's going to go up on YouTube, that Minister Muhammad of the New Nation of Islam said that God went to school in Sodom and Gomorrah.
Well, that's what America is. It's the modern Sodom and Gomorrah.
Well, that may be.
So what are you talking about?
That's not anything to do with what we just said. It may be that America is a modern Sodom and Gomorrah. All right, can we get back to the message to the black man?
Did the scripture say that it was going to be in the days of the Son of Man?
This is what we started with, Minister Muhammad, and this is really what our audience wants to know. They want to know.
Well, the audience wants you to answer the question I just asked you.
They want you to. I don't know about the United States being Sodom and Gomorrah, sir. I really don't.
Well, the scripture says in the book of Luke and the book of Matthew that as it was in the days of Lot, so shall it be also in the days when the Son of Man is revealed.
Okay. So the Son of Man's already been revealed. His name was Master Farad Muhammad. So what does that have to do with you?
No.
No says who? Now, we have Elijah Muhammad saying yes. Now, who says no?
To the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. He says that he raises up one just like himself.
Okay.
The scripture says, I beheld one like unto
him. Here we go again. He's trying to get himself into being the Son of Man, but he can't do it from his own book.
I am he that liveth and was dead.
Okay. How about this?
Muhammad wasn't never no spiritually dead man.
Let's investigate whether Elijah Muhammad was even a prophet. Elijah Muhammad said in the message to the black man on page 305 that we cannot reach the moon. Would you address that?
The messenger did not claim that.
Now, I didn't say
305, you say?
I didn't say he claimed it. I'm simply reading it, and you can say that it's not in there if you want to, but I'm holding it up. I have it up on the screen, and I'm willing to put it up large enough in this book for them to zoom the camera in, and we can actually see it on the page. He did say, you cannot reach the moon. And then he went on to say that folks are trying to...
The messenger didn't say that. He said, you can't reach the moon and live on it.
No, we'll go ahead and read the rest of it. He said, they now boast of building rockets to land on our moon, which they can't and won't be done. Now, you tell us, have we landed on the moon or not?
Why he lied?
Excuse me?
The messenger said you can't reach the moon and live on it.
We're reading the messenger right here.
I'm reading it too.
Look at it.
It's a whole complete sentence that
okay.
you read part of.
Okay, all right. Well, how about we take the other part on page 110, which is even clearer. It says, they now boast of building rockets to land on our moon, which can't and won't be done, and to build a small contraption to try to circle the Earth like our moon, which we have made to revolve around the Earth. Now, did they land on the moon, and do we have little contraptions that circle the moon? And did he say they couldn't do it?
Just a moment. What paragraph you on? You're not going to tell me where you reading at?
Now, you're God, and I'm having to tell you. Where'd you go to school, God? I'm having to tell you about your own book.
So, let me see. What did they say when they was mocking Jesus?
Are not Jesus, so how is it that you get it? Sir, you haven't even given a close representative of Jesus tonight.
Let me show you what we got going here.
Okay, here's what we got going. We got you trying to find your place in your own book. And we all can see it tonight before you get there that Elijah Muhammad, is he looking in his book?
Okay.
We see you. We see you looking in your book. It's on page 110.
I asked him, where are you reading at?
I'm reading from page 100.
You supposed to know where I'm reading.
I'm reading from 110. I just told you.
And I asked you what paragraph.
And I'm not telling you. You're God. You find it.
Oh, I see. This is how we show our intelligence. You know, that's the one thing that you all have always feared, and it has now come upon you. You always feared for the black man to be on equal footing with you because you knew he could outdo you.
And do we look afraid?
Right now.
Do we look afraid?
Just like...
Do we look afraid? Mr. Muhammad, do you realize that I'm going against my doctor's advice? I was diagnosed with colon cancer Monday a week ago, and I'm going against all my doctor's advice. We've bought extra time here. We've bought 3 hours of time in Michigan, and we're doing all of this so that we can be afraid of you?
I don't have no kind of cancer.
What's that now?
I don't have any kind of cancer.
I know that you don't, but see, I'm saying all of this is on the against me side, and still I was willing to come on and have this discussion with you because I'm afraid? Is that
now
really?
I understand why you're so disrespectful.
Now I'm disrespectful. All I'm doing is asking you to find your own place in your own book because, you know, I actually might have it wrong. Now, I tell you what I do.
That's why you in the shape you in, because you're so disrespectful.
Oh, you're saying I have cancer because I disrespected who?
Me?
Well, I didn't even know you when I was diagnosed.
Been working in the day that you were told not to.
Okay, now what's going to happen when I get well? Is that going to be because of you?
The book says, are you not going to get well?
You don't think so?
Not after tonight.
Well, even if I don't, I've already told the community that if I go, I said hallelujah to the whole community. So there's nothing on you either way.
Learning how you were supposed to act toward me?
Okay, how was I supposed to act?
All of them told you, it says, sanctify the Lord of hosts himself, and let him be your fear.
You are the Lord.
And let him be your dread.
That's what you're telling our audience tonight, that you're the Lord.
To teach you that the Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath day.
Can you find that where the moon and I said 110. I don't think it's on page 110, but I know it's in the book, and God can't find it. Okay. All right, now he's back to saying that he's the Lord again, and I shouldn't be on here. Now, listen,
stop
folks, did you not say that I shouldn't be doing this to you?
I mean, you running around here being disrespectful and don't know you being
satellite
good at
would
me.
Be the word that you have to look up on the internet.
You should have you should have traveled in the earth like the Quran say and see what was the end of people who went down the road you traveling right now.
Listen, sir, me having cancer doesn't have anything to do with you.
I ain't had no business coming in here being so difficult.
Okay. All right. So, folks, I'll tell you what. We'll let our community judge again. Now, the only thing he has, he doesn't have his book. We have Elijah Muhammad saying that, and he knows it's in there. We have Elijah Muhammad saying that it's actually on the same 305. So, let's look at 310.
It's paragraph 3 of... page 110.
Okay.
She holds a whole nation, so-called Negroes, prisoner. talking about America, and refuses to open the door of freedom, justice, and equality to them. She threatens to go to war against other nations who hold any of her citizens prisoners. You remember when Jimmy
Keep reading. Don't stop. Keep reading. We wanted you to read the part about you cannot make...
At the moment, I got a right to comment on things.
Okay, go ahead.
When Jimmy Carter was president, the Iranian people took about 50 hostages, American white people.
Oh,
and it was a few black people that they let them go. But the point is, when they told the American people, over 50% of the American people said we ought to go to war. As the messenger said, if anybody withholds freedom, justice, and equality from her people, she threatens to go to war against other nations who hold any of her citizens prisoners. They now boast of building rockets to land on our moon.
Now, how'd you get Jimmy Carter into that? Did you just put it in there on your say-so?
You notice he don't want me to read it.
No, we love it. We love what you're doing. Let's go back to our screen and make sure that our audience sees that he's trying to figure out now how to get Elijah Muhammad...
...the earth like our moon, which we have made to revolve around the earth. Now, that didn't say nothing about you wasn't going to reach the moon.
Oh, let's go back to it one more time.
Now, let boldface lie.
Okay. Let's see.
He didn't want to tell me where he was reading it.
Okay. Now, I'm reading the part where it says, they boast of building rockets to land on our moon and to build a small contraption to try to circle the earth like our moon, which we have to made to revolve around the earth. Now, why is it that you didn't read that? Or did you read that?
I just read it.
Okay, now, did you say that they now boast of building rockets to land on our moon, which can't and won't be done? Did I insert that? Or is that in the book?
It says, they now boast of building rockets to land on our moon and to build a small contraption to try circling the earth like our moon.
Okay.
Which we have made to revolve around the earth. It didn't say nothing about not being able to.
Okay. Now, are you saying that he was saying in the other passage that I read that we can't...
Why do you have counsel?
Here we go. You can't reach the moon.
Here we go.
Can we reach the moon?
According to your scientists, you already have.
Did I hear you correctly?
Yes.
Are you saying that you don't think that we've really been to the moon?
I said that you couldn't reach it. He said you can't live on it.
No, it did say you can't reach it. Now, anyway, you want to...
Reach it and live on it.
Okay, thank you. You did say it right that time. Reach it and live on it. Now, the live on it part is yet to be seen. But the reach it part, we have done. Now, is your prophet half wrong? Are half right.
You can't reach it and live on it.
Can you reach it?
Yes.
All right. That's half of it. So will you say that he was wrong about that, or did you say that he never really meant to say that?
The thing your scientists found when they went there was that the moon at one time was part of the earth.
Okay. I was hoping that you would go there too. So you're now telling us that the moon used to be a part of the earth.
Yes.
Now, did the moon turn over and pour water out on the earth?
Yes, it did.
Okay, let's go to my slide. This is page 109 of Message to the Black Man. Man is easily made, but the sun, moon, and stars are much harder to make, yet we are the makers of them. In making the moon, it was not our original father's intention to make the moon as it is. His real intention was to destroy the moon, but failed, and all others who make such attempt will fail.
No, his original intention wasn't to destroy the moon. It was to destroy us.
Okay. Now,
that's what he said.
Did I misread it?
You sit up here and you done misread everything that you read.
Let me go back. Let's see. Page 109.
What paragraph are you at?
Now, listen, God. I am not going to sit here and tell you about your own book. It's really, you know, in a way, it shouldn't be in my camp to have to bring all your stuff up, but I'm doing this for the audience. I'm putting it all up on there so they can see it, and you don't even know where it is in your own book. Don't you have some guys there that can help you?
You remember when I asked him about the other paragraph and found out when we got there that he didn't read what was there?
Okay, I will tell you this. I will say to the community that, in fact, what we did in order to save time is we went to the internet and we brought the internet version in. Now, I'm going to go...
If man is easily made, But the sun, moon, this is the last paragraph on page 109, message to the black man. It says, man is easily made, but the sun, moon, and stars are much harder to make. Yet, we are the makers of them. In making the moon, it was not our original father's intention to make the moon as it is. His real intention was to destroy the moon, and then he put in parentheses there, Earth.
Okay, who put in parentheses?
How come you didn't read that?
I said, who put in parentheses there?
Yeah, that's in the message to the black man that the messenger was explaining what he meant when he said
okay,
moon.
So now he's calling
the part of the earth.
Fine, I'm fine with that. So you're telling us the moon is the earth?
No.
So
at
did
that
he
time,
did,
it was a part of the earth, and that's why he said his original intent was to destroy the moon, meaning earth.
Okay, so what we've got to believe is the moon used to be the earth, and his original intent was to destroy the earth or the moon?
The earth.
The earth. And the earth is the moon in parentheses.
No, the moon is a part of the earth. The earth is not the moon.
It doesn't say part of the earth. It just says the moon in parentheses, the earth. So you're accusing me of actually not knowing what your prophet is saying. And I'm going to tell you, this is a little bit difficult for the regular person out here because none of us ever heard anybody say that the moon was the earth or that the moon came from the earth or that the water that is on the earth actually came from the moon. And we got this from a guy. Did Elijah Muhammad go to any schools, by the way?
I never taught you that the water that's on the earth came from the moon.
You told us just a minute ago it did.
Do no such thing.
What did you say? Excuse me?
That part of our planet, which is called moon, was blasted away from the earth, and when it went out so far, it turned over, and that water that was on that part spilled back down here to the earth. Now, if you say that didn't happen, explain to me what Noah's flood was all about.
Okay, that's fine as far as the community is concerned. What we want you to hear is that Minister Muhammad says...
you say that didn't happen.
All I want to do is clarify it, sir, because we want to put this up on the internet later. Minister Muhammad says that the water in the flood of Noah came from the moon. Is that what you're affirming?
I'm asking you. Since you say that what the messenger said wasn't true.
Listen, I never make up stuff like that. All I know is what the Bible says about the rain.
Wait a minute. Who called us Negroes?
Are we moving again?
No, you just said you don't make up nothing. You open that door.
I said I don't make up anything, and now I've called you a Negro.
Oh, this ain't just something, a Caucasian that say he don't make up nothing.
Now, how did I get to be calling you a Negro from me saying that I didn't make up anything about the moon pouring out water?
Asking you, where did we get the name Negro from? Y'all made that up.
Now, how did we get from that? From Noah's Ark, from the flood, and the water on the moon, to you saying that I made up that you were a Negro.
So if a person, even in court, if you
now we're
are
back
accused
in court.
Of committing something.
Now we're back in court.
Crime. And
at least we're not in the mental institute. I've gotten out of the mental institute and we're back into court. So I think I'm coming up in the world. Go ahead.
You haven't gotten out of it. You proved that that's where you belong.
In the mental institute or in court?
I would never make the statement if I was one of you that I don't make up nothing.
Okay, now, what was a bigot?
That you made up a lot of stuff already.
Could you tell us what a bigot was again? Now, don't tell me it's the state of being a bigot. I need to know what really a bigot does. Because now you've said that I started out a story that you were a Negro, that I started that. Or you said y'all. Now, how did I get connected with y'all?
A bigot.
Yeah, tell me what a bigot is. Don't tell me that it's the state of being a bigot. Actually, give us some definitions from a better dictionary.
Oh, just wait. I'm reading to you the definition of bigot.
Okay.
It says a person of strong conviction or prejudice.
Prejudice?
In matters of religion.
Prejudice, did you say?
Especially in matters of religion, race, or politics.
Okay. In matters of race... religion and politics, I do not have a problem with the black man, and I don't have a problem with intermarrying with the black race at all. As a matter of fact, the church that we're in here in Virginia is a mixed interracial congregation. We do not have this problem that you're talking about, but yet...
You asked me to give him the definition of bigot.
I did, because I'm trying to figure out who really is a bigot.
When I start reading it, he is condemning it.
No, I'm trying to find out who really is a bigot.
I'm going to read this.
Okay, you go ahead. Now, he's real interested in the dictionary.
A person of strong conviction or prejudice, especially in matters of religion, race, or politics, who is intolerant of those who differ with him. That's you.
Okay. Now, what about the New Nation of Islam? Do you have any white people in the New Nation of Islam while we're talking about intolerance? Any white people in the New Nation of Islam there in Mississippi?
You know what? It's not my fault that you don't come. You could convert and become a follower yourself.
So you're saying, was that a yes or is that a no? It could be on you, Minister Muhammad, because, you know, in the church where I am, we have black and white. Now,
you like it here.
You know what? I actually enjoy that, and it may be that I'm a better minister to the black race than you are to the white race, because you said it was on the white race because they didn't come. Well, it could be on you. Did you ever stop and think about that?
No, sir. It's not on me. The scripture says...
Oh, now we go into the scriptures again when this New Nation of Islam is not even in the scripture. Why don't you just convert to Christianity? Why don't you convert to Christianity so you can use the Bible all the time and get rid of this book that's hurting you?
Get rid of what book?
This message to the black man. It hasn't done you any good tonight.
I'm going to get rid of message to the black man. The message to the black man is not false. The message to the black man is true.
Okay, are you...
It's my fault because you try to reinterpret and misinterpret what you're reading.
Okay, are you...
That's what you did with the Bible.
All right, let's go back to my screen. Are you Allah?
Okay, now I will answer your question. The messenger said this. He said, we all are Allah. And when he said, we all are Allah, he was talking about all of the prophets and messengers collectively.
Okay, but I'm a messenger, so I like that when you said it the first time. I'm Allah too. And since now that I'm Allah, I actually know your book as well as you do. You talk about me misinterpreted, but you can't even find your place. Let's look at page 109. What? You disbelieve it? Do you not see the devils are trying to make themselves satellites? Sir, are we devils? Would you tell our community who the devils are that are making the satellites? Now, you already got it clear a while ago. Let me remind our audience. You said Jimmy Carter's days, and you talked about folks in Jimmy Carter's day, and you were talking about them making rockets, and you were actually talking about the white folks back then. Now, who is the devils?
We made you. We know what we made you.
Okay. Now, I see why you don't have any white folks in the Nation of Islam.
Oh, that's not the reason. There's plenty of white people that respect us, and one day will follow me. I'm not worried over that.
One day. Now, you've been going since 1973, did you say?
It wasn't time.
1973, and you haven't been able to get a white person to follow you yet? 1973.
There's plenty of white people that are learning from me right now with this, and you are a big embarrassment to them.
I'm a big embarrassment to you?
Ah.
Okay. I'm glad to hear that.
Embarrassment to
you. I'm glad to hear that.
White people.
I'm glad to hear that I'm an embarrassment to you, but it's not because I'm a bigot, and it's not because I have a problem with anybody who is in the black race. I'm trying to make a difference, Mr. Muhammad.
That's what I said just now.
What?
They say you was a big embarrassment to me.
What'd you say?
That's what I told you. You're a bigot.
What did you say?
I said you are a big embarrassment to white people.
Okay. I think we'll play you back tomorrow night, now that you've clarified that you didn't say that. And if you didn't say it, I will be glad to apologize. I thought I heard you say you're an embarrassment to me.
Did I? How many?
Now, here's what we're asking. Do you not see the devils are trying to make themselves satellites to make you believe that they are the masters of heaven and earth as it is written of them in the Bible and the Holy Quran? Is this the language of a bigot, or is this the language...
Where are you reading it?
What?
Where are you reading?
You know, it amazes me that I spent the time to study your book so that I could bring it up to our community, and you don't even know your book. Did you say I'm an embarrassment to me, or are you an embarrassment to yourself?
I'm not pretending that I know where everything and on every page.
Do you know where anything is?
I have the book here, and since you're reading it, I would think that you would be glad to tell me where you're reading
it. It's
from.
On the screen, page 109.
I don't see your screen. Page 109 in what paragraph?
I'm not going to tell you the paragraph.
Yeah, I know, because you are a liar.
I don't know. It's because I don't want to spend the time, the mental energy, God, Allah. I don't want to spend the mental energy to go down through the pages when I've already spent all kinds of energy putting it up on the screen for our audience. What am I to you?
He said,
am I your servant?
You know, this is the thing. Now, this is a man that says that he's a messenger of God.
Okay, now I like this. This is what we have preachers do in this area. When they don't do good, they apologize by basically taking it out on me. Listen, Mr. Muhammad, everybody in the community knows that you all challenged me. Is that not true? You didn't like the way Malvester did. Is that not true?
I didn't call you. You called me.
I did not call you. Jamar called me and said that the New Nation of Islam did not think that Malvester was a good representative. Now, we've let you come on. I've supplied your book on the screen for our audience, your audience in Detroit. You don't know where the pages are. I'm gracious enough to tell you the page, but I'm not going to spend the time to go down through here and let my mind get diverted while I concentrate on finding your paragraph. And what am I? I'm not a good minister. I think I'm being pretty nice to you.
Question for you. How many times have you seen a preacher preaching the Bible or any scripture who refused to tell you what verse he was reading from?
How many times have you ever had a book to deal with that doesn't have verses?
You don't have to have verses. I asked you what paragraph.
Well, listen, a verse is much easier than finding a paragraph, sir. And not only that, I don't study your book like all the rest of the preachers study the Bible.
You would tell me the last paragraph.
The last paragraph.
Go and start looking for what you was reading.
Okay, now did you found it in the last paragraph?
You didn't want me to go there because...
Listen, there's no need for you to go there. It's on the screen.
It says, and I told you before that I don't see your screen.
Oh, well, all right, I apologize for that. You have your book then. We're back to the same thing. Look it up in your book. I took the time.
You wouldn't have to keep apologizing if you wasn't so disrespectful.
No, I am trying to be a gentleman, and when I know that I'm wrong, I will apologize. Now, how about this? How about you show your gentleman nature and retract that you're calling us devils?
That you claim to believe in, you have not lived up to, which is as you would that men do to you. Do ye also unto them.
Sir, when we talk about false teachers, I'm not under obligation to let false teachers have a pass.
Well, now, you know,
we're going to quote scripture here. Let's go to Matthew chapter 23 and let's see how Jesus dealt with false teachers. I don't think Jesus basically did unto them as he wanted them to do unto him in the sense that you're trying to make that out to be. Jesus...
Nicodemus said to the people.
No, we're not in Nicodemus. We're in Matthew 23.
Well, we can't.
Matthew 23. Let's go up to the screen right quick because we're fixing to be out of time on our program. Then spake Jesus to the multitudes of his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore whatsoever they bid you, observe that whatsoever they do. But do ye not after their works,
going,
for they say and do not.
The scriptures, where you keep on talking about I'm an infidel or whatever.
I didn't say infidel tonight.
He was already after Joseph.
I did not say infidel tonight, but I did say that you're sitting in Elijah Muhammad's. You're sitting in either Elijah's seat.
I never told you I was sitting in Elijah Muhammad's.
Okay, you're sitting in Master Farad's seat then.
I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I'm sitting in my own seat.
You're not sitting. This book doesn't say that you have a seat.
Didn't nobody have to get up and give me no seat?
Okay. How did you get to be where you are? You just said so.
Was my place all of the time, even
okay.
Before.
Now that is, in fact, what they did in the Bible days as well. Let's turn to Matthew chapter 15, verse 9. They basically worked off of their own traditions. Look at this. But in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrine the traditions and commandments of men. You're basically basing your position off of your own say-so. Mark actually says that it was...
The position that I was basing myself on, you never heard.
Okay, you did tell me that you were the one as result of your own say-so.
The book says, no, I didn't tell you that.
What book?
You are a liar.
What book?
I never said that.
Now you were upset with me about saying infidel, and I didn't say infidel. Now you've called me a liar tonight. I'm a mental patient. I'm a liar. What else was I? A bigot. I'm a bigot.
I'll judge any man before it hear him. You notice he didn't hear me not out of the whole 3 hours.
I have heard you well, and I heard you on Hoger's on the debate.
The only thing you told the truth about was the fact that you have cancer.
Now, I don't even know that.
Yeah.
That I don't know that I have cancer. I'm going on the doctor's say-so. But you know what? They showed me some pictures, and you hadn't showed us nothing tonight. You're a guy from Mississippi that wants to be Elijah Farad Muhammad. You want to be Allah. You want to be, who do you want to be?
Beta Doctor.
You want to be Son of Man, but you just can't get there. And so you said that Malvester Muhammad didn't do a, no, your people said Malvester Muhammad didn't do a good job. So you wanted to get on and make your debut here in Martinsville.
Who is Malvester Muhammad?
He's the gentleman who had the first discussion with us that Jamar said did not do a good job representing the Nation of Islam. So now you're on here tonight. Now,
First of all, when he was talking with you, it wouldn't be intelligible anyway, because this whole night you haven't let me finish one sentence I started.
One sentence, did you say? You just finished a sentence.
Yeah. And you said we're out of time.
No, we're not out of time. I said we're almost out of time. We're never out of time on our broadcast.
I'm not out of time. I said
we're never out of time on our broadcast either.
You know, this is what you're going to notice the difference between me and Malvester.
Okay.
This is the difference.
Okay.
You're going to pay for how you acted with me.
Okay. So is that a threat? What are we getting into now?
Now, the scripture says that.
The scripture says that I'm going to pay for how I treated the new Nation of Islam, but I don't know anybody in the new Nation of Islam that's mentioned in the scripture, nor by Farad Muhammad, nor by Elijah Muhammad. So how do I know that you're even in any of this at all?
You don't.
I don't. You're right. Neither does the community.
Because you never would let me show you. It's not bothering me, but it's going to affect you.
Okay.
Of how you acted in this
fight. I got it. Okay, so you couldn't do a good job on our debate, so now you're telling me that I'm going to get my due later. Is that what you're telling our community?
I could not force you to be quiet and let me speak. That's your choice.
I said, are you telling our community that I'm going to get it later?
Oh, you getting it now.
Okay,
nothing,
and so, you know, on Tuesday of last week, I believe it was, we actually had an interview. They interviewed me because I have cancer, and that's exactly what the screen said. Is Johnny getting his due? And a lot of these folks around here called up, and that's what they said. They said, Johnny is finally getting his due. So here's my question. Am I getting my due from the Pentecostals who prophesied, or was it, in fact, a late prophecy from Minister Muhammad? Who's right?
No, sir, you're not getting your dues from none of these religious people.
Who am I getting my dues from?
From God. That's what he said.
Okay. Now,
he said, whosoever fall on that stone shall be crushed.
You're the stone?
That stone fall on shall be ground to powder.
Are you the stone?
Yes.
So you are the stone.
That's right.
Okay. Now, how do we determine that you're the stone?
You when you see what Allah do with what you just did tonight.
I thought he actually qualified that when he talked about that stone. He actually talked about these individuals having their city destroyed and their nation taken away from them.
But themselves told you that he had many things to say to you, but you can't bear it now. He said, but when he, the Spirit of Truth has come.
No, you moved out of the scripture that you were.
He will guide you into all.
You moved out of the scripture that you were in.
The quickest way you can tell when a person truly loves God is how they act when you recite God's word to them.
I'm going back to God's Word. What we're going to do is show how we love God's Word. The way we do that tonight is we actually put it up on the screen.
You can't go back to where you never were.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're talking about you going back to the Word of God. You never were in the Word of God.
I'm saying the way that you tell a person loves God's Word is you go to the place where the things were being said. Now, you are saying...
You've already shown...
Now, I'm just going to put this up right quick. Matthew chapter 21...
Attempted to show you why I'm saying I'm the Son of Man according to Scripture.
No, we're going to let the Scripture. We're going to let the Scripture talk. Don't get excited.
All right. I'm not getting excited. Now, I'm telling you why you in the face.
No, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the context. Right here is the context of what you just said.
Okay. Now, I don't need you to.
Wait a minute. I know where my Scripture is. You don't have to tell me what paragraph it's in. Just hold up. Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth fruits thereof. Whomsoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken, but on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind them to power. Now, who is the nation?
You right now.
Who is this kingdom of God shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth fruits? Now, are you saying that this was a prophecy about whom and what nation was involved?
Sir, I didn't tell you this was no prophecy of Yaqub.
I didn't say Jacob.
I ain't never told you nothing about this.
Who brought up Jacob?
Yes. that is a prophecy of the new nation of Islam.
Oh, this is?
Yes.
Okay, let's get it. The kingdom of God shall be taken from whom and given to whom?
Kingdom of God has already been taken from you all. That's why you got men standing up on City Hall trying to marry a man.
Okay, now here you are since 1973, and you haven't been able to get any more followers than you have. And you're telling me this prophecy. You know what, Mr. Muhammad? Are you 60? Aren't you 60?
The scripture says this.
Aren't you 60?
Scripture says that broad is the way and wide is the gate that leads.
Why do you want to leave this scripture? We were in this scripture giving you a chance to look at it. Now you're 60 years old, and in 1973 is when you started, and you're telling me that you're leading the new nation of Islam to take away from who are you saying when you said you?
The kingdom already been taken from everybody.
Everybody? Now that's pretty vague. Who is everybody?
That's why I can stand up out here and not be like you, bigoted. I can let people talk. I can let people say whatever it is they think they have. And after they finish, then I can address what they say point for point.
Okay.
It's like with me and Mr. Neubauer. Now, Mr. Neubauer, I never cut him off before he made a point.
Oh, really?
The only time I stopped him was after he made a point and went to go to something else. I say, wait a minute, stop.
Do y'all know if Mr. Neubauer is still on the...
Mr. Neubauer has already called me and made an arrangement for us to have a face-to-face.
Now, didn't you say on live television that you doubted that he would do it?
I did, and that's how I know he would.
Now, isn't that a little bit of a bigot right there?
I know y'all. See, you won't prove me wrong. That's what you want to do.
Okay. We're going to have Mr. Neubauer on the line here, I think.
You ain't doing nothing but proving me right.
Okay. Now, on live television...
I said just now.
On live television, a man tells you that he's going to have you into Michigan, and what I hear from him is that you are not willing to actually sign up to come to Michigan.
Well, if he told that,
let's hear him.
Yeah.
All right, let's put him on speakerphone.
According to Brother Michael.
Hey.
What did he say?
Holger. We got Brother Neubauer on the line, Mr. Muhammad, and what we want you to do is we want you to affirm or deny that you're going to Michigan so Brother Neubauer can get this thing settled. Are you coming to Michigan or not?
Just a moment. I want to talk to Mr. Neubauer.
He's listening.
Okay, Mr. Neubauer, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Did you have a miscommunication with us, or was that already said?
We've already said that, yes. We've got our debate set up for May the 7th at Foundry Hall in South Haven, and we just want to make sure you're coming.
Thank you, Mr. Neubauer. We already said it, didn't we?
Are you coming? Are you coming? We want to hear you say you're coming, Mr. Minister Muhammad.
I just said it.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
How about you say it again? We missed it.
Thank you.
We missed it.
I don't have to lie. I already told the people that I would let them know. And I've been getting ready to start advertising.
You getting ready to?
Tell me I'm going.
You getting ready to?
Before we said it.
Okay, Holger, are you satisfied that he's coming?
Yes, I think he's coming, yes.
Okay.
He told you.
Appreciate that.
That's the beginning, we had already said
it. We got it all planned for him to come.
All right, you got everything planned.
Tell that lie and say he told you that he didn't know.
Okay, Brother Neubauer, did you tell me this afternoon that you weren't sure that he was coming?
Well, this is what I'm not sure about. Because he said that he didn't want to have a discussion where we had so much time to speak. I suggested we have two 10-minute speeches, and then we could have as small, little as 3-minute intervals of speeches. But I didn't want him interrupting me like we did the last time.
No, he says, no, Holger. He says he never interrupted you. He's been telling our audience tonight that I'm a bigot and that I'm mistreating him and that he never interrupted you. So are you saying he interrupted you?
Oh, sir, that's not what I... How do you tell that lie?
And spoke twice as long as I did. He took two times as much time on air than I did. I don't want that kind of discussion. I want a fair and balanced discussion.
I told you that every time Mr. Neubauer finished a point, before I let him go to the next one, I told him I wanted to address the point he made. That's what I told you, and that's what I did.
Do you think he let you finish your points, Holger?
No, he did not let me finish my points, nor did he stay in the same scripture I wanted to explain. And I want to have a fair discussion, and I want to have equal time. And I think that's the best way to do it.
So then you can't lie and say that I didn't make a point.
He's saying that...
Made a point. Before you went on, I would always stop you until you let me address that. Don't tell me I didn't let you make a point.
He's disputing what you said, Holger. We do appreciate you calling in and giving your perspective on it.
All right, thanks.
All right, goodbye.
You notice ain't nobody in the audience calling up corroborating nothing that y'all saying.
I tell you what, if you want us to start with the calls, we'll definitely do it. We, out of respect to you because you couldn't hear our calls, we quit taking calls.
People that's in your audience didn't hear us. But the people in the audience...
Oh, sir, yes, they did. People in our audience heard every bit of that. We got our tech stuff going.
Well, then, why you tell the lie and say I didn't let the man make his point?
He's the one who said that. I didn't say it. He said right there on our audience and here in our audience that you did not let him hear make his point. And we're going to play the debate later, too. We'll let our audience decide. I already listened to it. You didn't make him make his point. And you were boisterous. You were... just, man, a man in control. But on our broadcast, where we've had all of this technical stuff to be able to show your scriptures, show your books, you have just been a puppy. And we have enjoyed it, I will tell you. Even though you say that we're bigots, we're devils.
I'm saying
and you said now I'm a liar.
That I have always been, if you check any of my meetings out, I've always respected people. I'm the one that people disrespect. You can't accuse me of no disrespect. I didn't disrespect none of y'all.
I didn't say you did disrespect. I'm fine with the way you do your programs or whatever. I just say you don't like it when it's done to you the same way. I have not complained one bit about the way you do, sir. I am happy with the way
you do. What I didn't like is not the point that you would argue against anything I say. The thing that I didn't appreciate is the fact that you never let me finish saying it.
That's what you say.
That's not what I say.
That's what you say, and you say that you let Holger speak, but you didn't. So, but I'm saying, Mr. Muhammad, I am very happy with the way...
I know you are, but won't be after a while.
And other than the fact that you can make threats
about
what's going to happen...
You shouldn't have never done like you did.
Okay, that's fine. Now, folks in the community, he's basically saying that my cancer is a result of my treatment of him, but I had cancer before I ever met him. But anyway, that's fine. I can live with that, Mr. Muhammad. And if I pass on, you know what? You will know. I'm telling you now, I'll be the happiest in this whole scenario if I go on and pass on.
Why Isaiah told you to let him be your fear and let him be your dream.
There's no fear here. If there was fear, we wouldn't be here. Now, tonight, it must be the case that you don't like, out of your own mouth you've said it, you do not like the way that you have been done on the debate. I'm happy with you. I do not have a problem with your format.
Of this world.
I am not. I'm not in any way upset with your format.
Fear the tree.
Excuse me?
The messengers of God wouldn't have talked to me nearly like you did. They feared me.
Okay, here we go again. You've already said that you disbelieve all of the preachers. There is no such thing as Christianity. And now you wanting to bring them in as your witnesses. Do you really think they want to be your witnesses after the way you started the debate tonight? At the very first point, you said all religions are false and that you do not uphold any of them except for the one that you're in. Did you not say that?
I'm no preacher. I said all the messengers of God.
Okay. All right. We're on both lines?
Yeah, you take three first.
All right. Three is on the line. All right. All right. We've got it set up where you can actually hear the phone calls. Yes, caller, you're on live. Yes, caller, turn your TV down, and we're listening to you. Do you want to talk to Minister Muhammad?
Is you talking to me?
Yes.
I was calling in to confirm what Holger was saying earlier and what Johnny was saying earlier needed to be corroborated, that you were constantly interrupting Holger Neubauer. He was never allowed to finish a sentence, definitely not in the last hour and a half of the debate that Holger was on live with you. Never allowed to finish the sentence.
Let's see. You say that, but I got that on tape. Let's see if...
So will we.
Okay, and will y'all be broadcasting that in Michigan, ma'am?
It was broadcasted in Michigan. We watched it live.
I mean, will y'all be rebroadcasting it again?
I don't know about that.
Well, we're going to rebroadcast it here, and it will simulcast down there at some point. So I really appreciate you calling tonight, and I'm glad that you all are watching.
Thank you.
All right, thank you for the call. All right, let's see what we got on the other line. Are you wanting to talk to Minister Muhammad tonight?
Just a moment. I want to say something.
Okay, go ahead.
What was said?
Yes, am I live?
Yes, you're live.
I would just like to say on the New Nation of Islam, this is the closest thing to a cult that I have ever seen. It is ridiculous. And how many people that are following this, only God knows. And if you would take out your Bible and read it, if you cannot see this as a scam.
Okay, I have a question for you, ma'am.
I mean, this is the biggest scam I have ever seen that's ever come across a phone line, an internet, Johnny knows more about your book than you know, and you're supposedly some type of God. I don't want you for my God. Because my God can do things that I know you can't do, and he definitely knows his scripture because it's his own book.
I asked you a question.
I really think you need to take some time, sir, and check yourself out, and you definitely need a whole lot of prayer, and I will definitely be praying for you and peace and love, but if this come between a debate, there's not even no competition. Johnny outplayed you 10 times to nothing.
What do you think about tonight? Did he let me speak?
I think you're a scam artist, and I think they're all over the world. And I think we just found out another one.
What with you white people that don't like to answer questions?
Oh, how do you know I'm white, sir?
Well, I noticed you heard my question. Why did you ignore me?
Sir, I'm not white, so you are wrong. I am mixed.
Well, I don't care. I'm asking you a question.
Apparently, you did care because you asked the question. Now, I answered the question. I don't go, and I'm not one of those people about colors to start with, because God, if you were God, God is a spirit, and God doesn't dictate a color.
You didn't answer my question. I asked.
God has again outplayed you 10 to nothing. And I don't even, honestly, I watch Johnny. I agree with some of his points. I disagree with some of his points. But there was no debate tonight. Johnny was all the action. All you was a scam artist on the tube. I feel very sorry for you, and I will pray that people are taught the truth and that Johnny continues to bring out scam artists like you, like cults. This is like a cult where you have done now sucked and manipulated innocent people into this lie, deceitful tale of what type of truth you are teaching. It is a disgrace to the Word of God. This is a disgrace to God and his Word. Peace, love to you. Goodbye.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Boy, I do appreciate you being with us late at night, helping out. That was fantastic. Thanks for the call.
You told me I could talk to some of your callers.
I can't dictate how they feel about you. Remember, you don't really have that many followers. You already said, and I think you insulted her, so, you know.
Oh, I insulted her by asking her what a cult is?
No, you affirmed that she was something that she wasn't. Now, that's an insult, and I kind of think that's bigotry, if you really want to get down to it.
I heard that she was something that she wasn't. I didn't do nothing but ask her, what is a cult?
No, you actually asked, in fact, you didn't ask her nothing. You actually said something about her being white. What's with you white people? I stand corrected. It was a question. What's with you white people? That's what you said.
And what is with you white people?
But she said she wasn't white.
Well, if she's not white, then she don't have to get upset, do she?
No, actually, I would think that she would be upset because you actually positioned her as if a half-mixed black person cannot disagree with you. You see, that's what you did.
You don't like to hear a black man say something about and use the term white people.
You know what? You never did address about Farad Muhammad's genealogy.
You know that your position on anything like that is indefensible.
Was Farad Muhammad, was he mixed?
Yes, sir.
By the way?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now, Can you tell me how that God can actually be half devil?
The scripture says he came in the likeness of sinful flesh to condemn sin in the flesh.
But Farad would be half devil, would he not?
He came in the likeness of sinful flesh.
Okay, but he would be half devil, would he not?
To condemn sin. No, sir, he would not be half devil. He'd be half white.
He'd be half white. Well, but white is the devil. We already seen that. We go back to our slide right quick.
We didn't call you devil because you was white.
What did you call us? Why did you call us devils then?
We called you devils because that's what we made you.
Oh, okay. So you made us what we are, and we can't help ourselves.
Designated what man was the man of sin.
We can't help ourselves from what you made us, and now you're condemning us for what we became.
I'm condemning you for being what you
are. Okay, well, let's see what the community has to say.
Just a moment.
Okay, you're on. What does the Bible say?
I have a question for you. What is God?
What did you say, brother?
I said, I got a question for you. What is God?
Wait a minute. It's coming through a little distorted. Ask that again, brother.
Speak up a little bit, sir, if you can.
Okay, I'm asking you, Johnny. What is God?
What is God? Tonight, on our broadcast, it is Minister Muhammad from Mississippi.
Well, all right,
do you believe that?
Let's put him on the sideline for a second.
No, we're not putting him on the sideline. No, sir, we're not putting him on the sideline.
And you know what?
We're not putting him on the sideline.
Be on your hands. If you try not to win him over for the Lord, you just keep putting the man down. Try to win him over for Jesus. And why don't you quit trying to make out like you know it all when you really don't know nothing? Go back and read again, and if you lack understanding, ask God. He will give it to you. He says he gives it to all men that ask liberally.
Okay.
And so, look, man, just do this. Try to win the man over to Jesus.
Now,
quit trying to push him down all the time and have people calling in and dogging him.
Can we ask a question, sir? Are you out trying to win the Nation of Islam here in Martinsville?
Just a minute. Wait a minute.
I don't know nobody of Islam in Martinsville. I've never met one.
You know Malvester Muhammad.
Just a moment. When the man told you, what he just told you is just a civilized way of dealing with people. I mean, if you want to win souls over for whatever you claim to believe in.
Now, Minister Muhammad, you're actually telling me how to win souls. Now, you're talking to a white man. I will affirm that this is a white man. You're getting your chance.
I'm white as all day long.
Okay, all right, sir. He's getting his chance.
Half German, half American Indian.
Okay, he's getting his chance to minister to his first white person. Go ahead, Minister Muhammad.
You're not going to win nobody over by insulting people and not letting people speak. I mean, how many times did I tell you, okay, whatever you want to say, go ahead and say it?
Now, what you told Holger when you were on his broadcast is, you don't tell me what to do on my broadcast.
Sir,
I didn't need your permission to tell me what to do on our broadcast, Minister Muhammad. I didn't really need your permission.
But,
but here's the thing. You have a white person on the line, and you have never made a white convert. So how about you minister to him? We're listening.
I'm going to address what you said, and in the meantime, I am ministering.
Okay, we're listening. Go ahead and minister to him. Now, sir, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, you're being ministered to.
That he didn't have to worry about the time. I said, this is my broadcast. You don't have to be concerned about
it. Is that really how you said it? You said it so kind just then. Why don't you go ahead and tell us how you really said it?
In a humorous way.
It wasn't humorous.
I wasn't lambasting him. I was simply telling him, you ain't got to worry about the time. This is my broadcast. We got as much time as we need.
Okay, what I'll do is we'll play it for the community and we'll see.
I got something to tell you both then. Jesus said, by their fruits you will know them. You know, Muhammad, I don't know much about what you're preaching on, but Johnny. You need some help. You need some help. I'll tell you that right now.
Okay, we appreciate your call.
You ask God, he will give it to you. Cut me off. That shows me what kind of help you really need. Appreciate it.
We do appreciate you. All right, thanks for the call.
I love to talk to people that's willing to talk with
me. He just said he didn't know what kind of religion you were in, and I needed help, and then he went on. Okay, you're on What's the Bible Say?
You're not talking to me. You're talking at me.
We're actually listening to our callers. Yes, caller, you're on What's the Bible Say? Yes, you're on.
You just want anything to come up just so that you don't have to talk to me.
okay, if that's how you see it. But we always take calls, just like you did.
I'm sorry,
on your
I didn't
broadcast.
Take no call.
Yes, yes, caller, you're on live.
While Mr. Holger was on the air with me.
If he's God, tell him to heal your cancer.
Well,
say that again.
She said, if you're, she said, if you're God, why don't you heal my cancer? But see, you would rather. He's already said.
I'm not, everybody is given according to what the scripture says. That as thou hast done, says every man shall be judged according to his work, and have done in his body according to that which he hath done. That's what the scripture says.
Okay.
Don't ask me.
So there's no.
Don't I heal somebody?
There's no way that you would actually change your mind and like reverse.
What are you talking about?
You wouldn't reverse this curse. There's nothing that I could do to get you
I
to.
I can't reverse it. Just like Noah. Just
okay.
Like Noah, when God made his decision about closing the ark and these people going to be drowned, what nothing Noah could do?
How did you get to be Noah? I thought you were the Son of Man.
Scripture says, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the
okay,
days.
Okay, so God shut the door, but we're talking about cancer here. We're not talking about a flood. The flood was in Japan. We're over here in Martinsville. Now, you're
if
telling...
If you want it, if you, what kind of cancer do you have?
Are you a prophet? Are you a prophet?
No.
I thought you said a while ago that you were a minister and a prophet.
Oh, I did not.
So you're not a prophet? I'm... Say that again, you're not a prophet.
Alex, that you haven't been listening to me.
Okay, good. I want this for a good, this is a good clip too. Minister Muhammad is...
to me shows that you were not listening.
You're not a prophet.
I'm the Lord.
You're the Lord. Well, okay, how about the Lord tell us what kind of cancer I have? That's even better.
I just told you I'm not a prophet.
Well, the Lord, actually...
You got cancer. According to you.
Okay, now is the Lord greater or lesser than a prophet?
Show me in the scripture where the scripture says that the Son of Man would come and save people who disbelieved in him.
Okay, that's we were actually on another subject and you got off of it. We were asking you which is higher or
you own.
Lord or prophet. Now, surely if a prophet can see what is to come, the Lord who gives the prophets the inspiration.
I already told you what was coming, and I told you why.
No, we were talking about prophets. We're going to let you tell me what kind of cancer I have if you're the Lord.
You being shown why you are suffering.
Okay, I have skin cancer.
If I had any kind of illnesses and diseases, I would do like Mr. Reagan said. I'd err on the side of caution.
Okay. Well, I'm not Mr. Reagan. And Mr. Reagan.
Have you ever met me before?
While we're on Mr. Reagan, Mr. Reagan actually was an individual who was living in adultery. I'm not Mr. Reagan, and I am erring on the side of a caution. So I don't think he was very cautious.
In adultery.
Excuse me?
What do you mean he's a man that was living in adultery?
Now, sir, I thought you claimed to be the Lord, and you don't know that Ronald Reagan left his first wife and ended up living in adultery? He was actually in a relationship. Maybe you do need to watch what does the Bible say.
All of these things that you call yourself judging somebody.
That's not judging, sir. It was common knowledge that Ronald Reagan was living in adultery.
I don't know nothing about that.
Well, I'm sorry. The Lord doesn't know what is common knowledge to everybody else. You're on what does the Bible say.
The only reason that...
Prophet,
the only reason that...
He was the Son of Man. And originally it was... the Honorable Louis Farrakhan, and then it went to the other one, was named W.D. or whatever it was. It passed on to him. Is it that all of them are the Son of Man, or do they pass it along to each other?
This is not what you're talking about. I've been teaching since 1975. This is nothing but what it is. It ain't been transferred from one to another, to another, to another. I've been teaching this ever since 1975.
So all three of you are?
Well, I don't know nothing about what you're talking about, other people. I'm in here now. So this is the thing that I'm telling everybody, all of you. All of you are going to be held responsible for how you acted with me. Now, you can shrug it off all you want. You ain't never met me before. Ain't none of y'all never met me, but I heard of
it. See, there you wandering like you did with Johnny. I asked a simple question.
The scripture says
our God was supposed to be the Son of Man. He passed it on by logic wand, give it to him, and then he give it to you. What is all three of you, or do y'all pass it down the line?
And he's just asking a question, Minister Muhammad. The man is asking a simple question, and you're wandering around passing a curse on him now.
I don't need you to tell me what the man is asking. I'm listening. I'm asking.
Well, why are you passing on a curse to him?
No, sir, I didn't pass no curse on to nobody. You're doing that to yourself.
What about the
answer to the question?
The answer.
Three of you the Son of Man, or do y'all pass it down the line?
Understand something. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad ain't passed nothing to me.
So if he's the Son of Man, how did you be the Son of Man?
The Holy Scriptures, as the messenger told me in his word, his job was to raise me. After that, that was the end of his mission. And he told me that since I was expecting, he knew I would be expecting to talk with Master Farad Muhammad. And he told me, he said, well, if you want to talk to Allah, you read the scripture.
You know, caller, it sounds like a court of law that was in a while ago. The judge would say, that sounds like hearsay to me.
Well, you can have all of the scriptures are nothing but hearsay.
Okay.
Well, is it all three of you, or at the same time, the Son of Man, or does one have it for a little while, pass it to the next one, or?
When Moses said that God chose and sent him, that was hearsay. Because didn't nobody hear that?
Like three or four sons of man?
There is one difference, caller, between Moses. Moses came, and he actually did miracles to confirm that he was sent, and as a result, all of those people followed him out. Now, where is your following, Minister Muhammad, and where is your miracle or any confirmation? You don't even have confirmation from Elijah Muhammad, Farad Muhammad. You have no miracle. All you have is a group in Mississippi that is willing to broadcast you into Detroit. You never did tell us what happened in Detroit.
You notice, he don't even respect his own caller.
Sir?
That man
sir,
wasn't talking to you.
Am I disrespecting you, sir?
Talking to me.
Hey, son of man?
Yes.
Are you taking calls on this end as well?
Wait a minute. I'm going to take time, but let me finish with this man that's on here.
What's wrong? We'll be glad to entertain some of your calls, son of man. I mean, Minister Muhammad. I mean, Lord Allah.
Johnny.
That's fine. I told you, you don't have to. I'm just Johnny. I never was trying to get the big titles.
I mean, what's that about? I'm trying not to get out of here.
Sir, we're gonna go ahead.
The answer to my question is, one of you the Son of Man, or all of you the Son of Man?
And now that's the question that I wanted to answer. No, I'm the Son of Man that the book tells you would come in the last day. And many people, they forget that the Son of Man can't show up until the judgment. The scripture teach you that the judgment day, the Sabbath day, is the Son of Man's day, the Lord's day. And the Son of Man is Lord.
Okay, caller, I don't think you're going to get much more than that. We're going to let you go and get another call right before the end of the hour.
Why are you rushing that man off the phone?
Sir, do you mind if we let you go?
That's okay.
All right, thank you.
I'll listen.
Okay, thank you. All right, sir. Minister Muhammad, he wasn't upset, only you. All right, caller, you're on What Does the Bible Say?
Callers like that. I guess because
he was happy. He was happy. Don't be trying to plead his case. He's fine. What does the Bible say?
I guess because that man was willing to have a civilized conversation with me, you didn't want to hear.
No, he actually said you never did answer his question. You're on What Does the Bible Say? Yes.
No, that
yes,
man
caller.
Didn't say that.
Go ahead, caller.
Yeah, can you pull up that scripture where it says in the last days people will come saying that I am God.
That's in Matthew, the 24th chapter.
Now, he does,
and,
you know.
And tell what it says, the ending says.
Okay, now, I will call up verse 5 first. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. How about that? Matthew 24, verse 5.
And you notice, then, that the caller.
And you know what? I just want to say, Johnny, you keep on doing what you're doing. And many people around here is trying to criticize because you got counsel, but anybody can get counsel.
Thank you.
It don't mean that.
I know you don't want to hear it.
All you got to do is remember Joe, what happened to him.
It said about all of y'all. It says that
he had counsel and everything. Everybody left him. Everybody done everything.
I noticed y'all don't
okay.
like to hear.
Caller, it is 11:59, and we certainly do appreciate it, and I appreciate your kind wishes in regard to my sickness. Thank you for calling.
Okay, now the scripture.
Have a good night.
Okay, you too. Now, Minister Muhammad, it is 11:59 in Virginia. I don't know what time it is in Detroit.
I'm not worrying about what time it is.
Okay, but we agreed that we would go till 12 o'clock.
Well, we didn't. No. I ain't never told you no specific time.
Okay, we should have stopped at 11 then. Well, you would have been happy with that then, too. I wished I'd have known that.
I mean, everybody knows how I conduct myself with my broadcast.
We sure know it in Virginia now, and Holger knows also that you are upset with the way that you handled yourself on this broadcast. Now, it's 12 o'clock, and our listeners know that we all had this set up between myself and your ministers. I have them on tape if there's any dispute that we were going to 12 o'clock. Maybe you didn't agree, but they did. Thanks for watching. Always ask for what does the Bible say. God bless you and good night.
You left off line. You start off line and left off line. You know, brothers and sisters, I want to show you how, you know, this. I didn't want y'all to call up in Detroit. I know y'all want to get a piece out of me and all that. Don't worry about it. I got these wolves. I'm the shepherd, remember? Wolves don't frighten me.
Now, Mr. Muhammad, are you still there?
Out again. You said you were gone.
I didn't say I was gone off the phone. You just started lying again.
No, I'm lying. What did I lie about?
You said, well, you thought I was gone. I never said I was gone. We're
still recording.
I did think you were gone. You said you had to go.
Well, you're the Lord. You shouldn't be thinking. You should be knowing.
Oh, I see. So now you're the judge of what the Lord should and should not be.
Well, we simply are used to knowing when we read the Bible about the Lord. He is all-knowing.
Listen, the scripture says you couldn't even understand the Bible.
So what about you? Can you understand? Don't need it. Where's my mic? I asked you, what about you? Here it is. So you get to understand, but we don't?
Yes.
How come is that?
Because God told me, he said, son of man, if I say to the wicked that he shall die and you don't give him warning, then he shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at your hand. Why would he say that to me if you could read the book and understand it for yourself?
You know what, Mr. Muhammad, I think we have a caller whose son is in the Nation of Islam.
No, sir, I will take the caller if you keep your mouth shut.
Is that somebody that's sons in the Nation of Islam?
Yes, now let the caller talk.
Yes, Minister Muhammad.
Yes,
we have a gentleman on the phone. Mr. Grant, we have Minister Muhammad on the phone, and he knows that your son is in the Nation of Islam. Do you want to talk to him? Okay,
that
go ahead.
That man's dumb, foolish, because I don't know what. Are
you a member of the Nation of Islam, brother?
Brother, you can't be in the Nation of Islam. Because you made yourself look sick tonight on the airway.
Well,
I'll be honest with you. What in the world, Johnny's sickness got to do with y'all discussing the Bible? You know good and well, you were just as far from that as I am from the moon and on earth.
What's your argument if I had been able to put forth scripture?
Man, you can't tell me anything. I travel a lot. I used to be in the entertainment world.
I was trying to be honest with you, you look foolish
because you jump telling Johnny that the Lord is punishing him because of this and that, and that ain't what the debate is supposed to be about. You ain't no more God than I am.
No, this is what y'all all need. Y'all need to find that I'm who I say I am.
I'm going to tell you like it is. You should have stopped when you was ahead or trying to get ahead. You made yourself look foolish. I mean, what I got to do with the sick being Johnny's body?
I don't even listen to all this.
You know, if they were so comfortable, if they really, they wouldn't feel threatened by somebody who disagrees.
Don't talk indirect, because you're not talking to a non-educated person. I travel a lot.
Hey, Eugene, I don't know what he's saying. He's claiming, I tell you what, call up this number, what you say, what y'all is supposed to be talking about, Elijah Muhammad
started a year ago, message to the black man.
Push the button. There you
go. And you should have stayed on that. Why do you get off of that? Answer my question.
You can cut him off.
That's why you can't answer it.
He's not.
Because.
Don't cut him off if you want.
What'd you say? You're not going to cut him off?
Off if you want.
I'm not cutting him off. He's still talking to you, but I'm concerned that you're not talking to him.
I'm still on the air. I can't talk to him.
I'm going to be honest with you.
You can talk to him. He's listening to you.
I'm listening. That man's still running off at the mouth.
Eugene, he said that you're not listening. Would you tell him?